What's up, guys? It's Jason from Cool Home, and today we're going to talk about wall panels. Do you see my screen? And there, I've made really quick design options regarding the wall panels here. So let's get to it. How did you make those wall panels? Right. Let's use a different wall this time. Let's add it. So first, there's two ways to enter the construction tool. You can either click on the wall and hit wall editor. Another way is you can also activate a construction tool from the left side panel. So once we're in here, you can see that it's showing that the overall view of the room in our 3D window, but at the same time, we can take a look at this wall and design it in 2D, which is quite convenient. So in here, I'm going to do a brief introduction of what we have in here on the left side panel. So then first you have different finishes, which you can simply drag and drop into the wall. And then also you can have tiling options. So say if I change this to a marble finish, it's going to have a paving scheme generated. So once I click on it, you can see on the right side, I can do different kind of pavings, which means, this side also, right now you're looking at it because the size is a little bit large. So we can also adjust it here by typing, let's say, 30. And 30 by 15. You can see there you go, you have a quite smaller tile patterns. But to be noted that like this dimension ratio is recommended to match the original ratio, because otherwise as you can see, the pattern will not scale properly. But not to deviate too far from that, I just really wanted to demonstrate the possibilities of doing different paving pattern like chevrons. Okay, which might be better just using a floor right here if I use this. You have herringbone and you have brickwork, right? So enough with this. Let me just clear these patterns and go back to canvases. We also here have integrated wall panels, which you could drag and drop and place onto the surfaces. So it's also going to generate a paving scheme as well. And as you see, the paving scheme you have here, let me just zoom out here. You can also do customization, and it's fully parametric. First, you can do the angle of the paving. And second, you can see the horizontal offset, which means the texture itself, which you can change. And you can see whether you want a paving to start from the center or start from the right or left. You have different hard paintings. You have wainscot. This is really interesting and options. To me, that kind of all feel like, floating elements. So if you look at it in 3D, this is what a wainscot looks like. This is you're essentially adding a 3D model on top of the wall, and there's a way you can just scale it. And also you can array, which is a really nice tool. As you see, once you click on it, you can start panelizing the entire thing. As you see, it might not be the perfect width, right? So I'm going to show you how do you draw the actual perfect spaced out wall panel tool. Okay, so let's delete this. And let's clear the finishes using the eraser. Okay. So similar to the what we introduced in the construction tool in the previous video, you can use construction tool is very much like a SketchUp environment. So you can use rectangular to define the area you would like to push or pull. So you can see that. There's extrusion out, so if I type in like 6 inches, if I zoom in the 3D, You can see it exactly pushes out. So people might wonder, what if I want to push it in? Is it possible? But for unfortunately, this is not possible to push in on the native cool home walls. So I'm gonna leave it here to zero. So the really nice and neat trick here is, so I'm just going to erase this for now. Delete. Let's use the guidelines to divide it up the space first. Okay. So once you have one guidelines, escape out when and you click on the guideline itself, you see the array too. This is super useful. So first, two ways of arraying the guidelines. Spacing. So you can either space out to be 6 inches apart, and this gives you the evened out guidelines. But for this case, since we are really designing the panel towards a fixed width wall, which could be any width, you can just specify the quantity. Let's say I want 12 panels on this wall. And this is what you're gonna get. And this is so it evenly spaces out for you. So what's even amazing here is once you draw the rectangular shape here, which very conveniently snaps to the wall. And I'm going to use a tool called offset. So then you can offsetting. So click on the surface and you see you can choose the distance of the offset. Let's say 3 inches here. And then once we have the offset, we essentially created two lines. So some of you might think this is too busy, too many dimensions. You can always turn it on and off here. We're going to leave on the spacing here, but turn off the lens, and then we're gonna leave on the extrusion. So once we click on it, you can see it's showing highlighted a bar that's showing the extrusion of the panel and typing 6 inches. So then we have created a wall panel like this, right? So the next trick is going to be really useful, and you guys are gonna love it. Is once we have this and we can select the entire thing. Okay. Shift, select, and you can duplicate it an or array. Let me see if I can group it too. I've never done that. So no, it doesn't work. So arraying tool. Do you see what happened here? Like once you start arraying it, it just automatically fill in the space and with all the required, according to the guidelines, because that's how we designed it in the first place. So planning ahead is really important, and I'm just going to release here. Let's go back to our 3D preview, and there you go. You have just created a pattern array. Similar, if you want to add more elements, want to be more like a grid panelized system, you can do that too. So this is how you essentially create an array. So let's explore some other really interesting options. First, once you have a width of it, if you click on the edge of the line, it'll be showing do you want to set this as a light strip? That means do you want it to have a cove lighting at this panel? What does that look like? Let me just show you. I can just Google here. So let's Google cove lighting. Add wall panels. So this is kind of lighting that we're looking for here. And Cool Home have provided a one-click solution to add that lighting. So whether we want it to be indented or extended external expansion, which is a slightly different detail. So if you see the indented essentially is taking a part of this, it's creating a cove here and it's offsetting. Because this dimension is critical, so we need to go to the section edit to see where is our limit. Right, this 6 inches, remember, this is the offset that we have. So the indented, the corner line here, this is the dimension we should be taking care of. So if this our offset is only 3 inches, so there is no way for the lighting cove to hold something that is more than 6 inches. So we should essentially change it to 1 inches, which this looks a little unreasonable. But did you see the dashed line here? This is showing that this is where the light coves are, as our 3 inches offset. So let's make it a bit more realistic. Let's say 2.5. Can't seem to type in 2.5. I'm just gonna add in 2. Think this is good. And I'm going to edit this to be 2 as well. So this is where you see, once you have done this, click on the line and you can switch the brightness. I'm gonna switch it to 2000, so when it render it is more obvious. And I'm going to change the color to be a yellow color. Okay. So once you have done one side, what you can do is you can click and use your shift key to select both of them and use another shift key here. And you can set all of them as indented as well at the same time. So I'm going to switch to 2000 as well. Change that to yellow. I'm gonna change it to 2. I'm gonna change this dimension to 2. This is a section cut. It's basically cutting through the panel itself. If you're not familiar with the architecture term, I'm gonna hit OK. I'm gonna hit Save. And let's render and see what it looks like. Okay, let's go to render bar and let's take a look at this side. Let's do a preview. And you can already see there's a really shallow gap that's been created. Do you see that? So this proves that the lighting is actually leaking out of this wall panel. Okay, let's get to how do we make some of the moldings or sort of different shape of the wall panels as well. Let's go back to our construction tool. Wherever you want to go to construction tool, oh, I didn't know you could duplicate that as well. This is interesting. Maybe you could duplicate to a different wall. Okay, never mind. I don't think that worked. Oh, it did. Yes. See, this is something I just discovered too. You could actually duplicate your design into another wall. And that looks like the result is just mirrored. So let me just try to duplicate this to another wall. Apply it here. There you go. Okay, let's go back to our wall editor, also the AKA construction tool environment. And we got some crazy dimension here. We can just, we only need the spacing, or we don't even need the spacing. Let's just check it out. So we can do some other things like we can do is filleted edges, chamfers. So this is an interesting feature. So if I click outer fill, it gives you the option to create an arc that finishes. So if you select more lines, I'm just select all of them. And you'll be able to chamfer all of them at the same time, like this. Okay, this actually looks quite interesting, like this shape. I'm gonna turn off the extrusion as well, as it's become a bit annoying now. So select all line again. I'm gonna show you. So do different chamfer. Okay, let's do this one. And then I'm going to do select chamfer, and then a kind of looks like a little battery patterns. So enough with the shapes. Once you have this, if you want to add a chroma molding, this is where you can find it. Molding's on the left side. And this is really important as you're applying it. Do you see that once I'm selecting this molding, let's say you want to apply this molding, right? It's going to show you which area you would like to apply. So let's do both. Let's hit the outer edge first. And for this one, let's hit the inner edge, and let's see what is the differences here. So if I zoom in enough, you can see the outer edge actually looks at it uses the surface, external surface, and it just create a molding all around it. It's kind of like a follow me command in SketchUp 2. And on the inside is using it's an inside just using the same thing, but instead it's create an internal wrap as well. So there's a tons of molding options that you can choose from. And also what's really interesting is this molding also work with curved edges. Yes, they do. And they could look really pretty, as I can show you here. You can see this is, the molding looks right now with the curve, which is really, really pretty. So that's with the molding. You can also draw different shapes like polygons, which I also just realized is just really cool. You can see once you select on this, you can select, whether you want an octagon, select eight, and you just become, and this just become one of the shapes. Then you can hit on it, and you can do extrusion, and you can do, let's say, 6 inches as well. So there you go. You have, we are constantly adding more features to it. Material brushes. Once we're done with this, we can also add, tiles or finishes, and let's add some hard paintings here. Let's see if you want to do these patterns, right? Japanese fish scale patterns, and you can use paving finishes. Okay, so material brush. This applies to two types of finishes. First is paving. So this is where you select and apply the paving or the textures, even the paint color across different panels. But you could also apply a molding finish, which essentially you're grabbing this molding that we just created here and you apply it to another areas. It doesn't work. Let me see if I could apply. Oh, the other way have to be molding as well. So, you could only apply to the area where you already has a molding finish. Okay. So I'm gonna hit OK. I'm gonna apply here. So supposedly, this molding has already been changed, but it's not really obvious. So I'm actually going to change it to something that is more easy to recognize in here. Let's change it to a green wood molding here. Okay. It's a molding finish. Apply it here. And there you go. So this is where you apply your entire molding of the walls and copy from different options. Yours can also show grid as well. This option, I don't use it as much, but that will be really helpful if you are trying to align something. You could be aligning, wall decoration pieces, right? You could be using the grid for that. You could also be adding a mirror, which I find, this one seems to be quite popular with a lot of users render, right? And you can array that as well, which could be quite interesting. So I'm just gonna get rid of here. So this is how you do all kinds of wall paneling and the lighting here. And I wish I had discovered the guideline too a little bit earlier, because it is really quite convenient, as you can see. I can, go ahead and create another guideline. Just making sure this is on the grid. And I can create a horizontal guide or vertical guide as well. So I can say if I wanted to do maybe six. So then this is your guide, and then you can essentially, create different. You can just create another rectangle here, and then you could be, let's say, I want it to be 3 inches. Okay, and then you can do extrusions. Just turn on the extrusion, and this is going to be 6. So, as you can see, like I can select this, and it's starting to use the quantity, the same thing, right? And applying it and see if it works, right? So I think 5. Okay, 5 works. And then another amazing thing is notice this. It also works horizontally as well. So you could also specify that I want a 12 on the X axis, right? So what really matters is where did you start this array to, right? So if I were to change this array to, let's select array. You see, it's not really following that because let me change this to 12. Believe we had a 12. Yes. And this is how you get that. Well, I think this supposedly should be perfect. So maybe we should go for 11. There you go. And then for this one, let's say 5. And then hit OK. And oh, I don't know why it didn't array to the other direction. Let me take a look. Control Z, always Control Z if you run into any issues. Do your array again. Okay, let's do quantity 11 and 5. Okay, it seems to only array within its own block. So I think this is something that I'm going to have to investigate a little bit. But you can see once you have separated the surfaces, the finishes will be separated as well. Means that you could have different finishes applied. Also, you can have a wall curtain here applied as well. So a lot of stuff can be done and achieved in the wall editing tool. And also once you click on it, you can go further into the surface editing, and you can just editing this entire panel, and you can add a border tile, right? And you can, this is going to the paving tool sections right now. We're not gonna cover to this details, but we're gonna cover in the later videos. So let's hit save. So whenever you have, any problem with design, you can always click eraser bar, which is going to erase everything. So be careful with that. But you can always, Control Z to get it back. And let's just hit save and go back to our our floor plan, and let's see what we have created here. And I'm just going to erase this wall. And let's do a render of it and see what it looks like. Okay. There you go. I'm going to say indoor nighttime. Indoor daytime is good. Well, there is no window here, so let's see. Okay, the render is ready. Ta-da! So, give it a try. So let me know if you have any issues using the wall panels in the YouTube channel. Comment below. Subscribe if you like us. And this is Jason. Thank you. See you.